is Craig Milroy. I'm one of the co-directors of the Product Realization Lab at Stanford.
And I'm Ian Connolly. I'm a former graduate student in engineering and current med student at Stanford University.
Ian, I've heard you've done a project that's gotten a lot of attention. It's very important. Can you tell me about it?
Sure. So our project was to create a low-cost and very easy-to-use clubfoot brace. And basically, clubfoot is a congenital birth defect where a child's feet are turned downward and inward, making it very difficult for them to walk. And it's a huge problem in developing countries because the bracing phase of treatment is very expensive, or the braces they have available to them are very difficult to use.
Mm-hmm. Did you find this project yourself, or how did you come about doing that particular project?
So we started working on this project through a course at Stanford called Design for Extreme Affordability. And you know, it was really born out of that class, and we continued to work on it using the resources here at the PRL for the past 2 or so years.
Mm-hmm. This seems like a big project. Were you working with a team, or were you doing it yourself?
Yeah, so we were part of I was part of a student team of four. Mm-hmm. Jeff Yang, a PhD student, Mike Adude, a medical student, and Katie Jacksheimer, a business school student.
So how do you tackle a problem like that? What steps did you take to try to come up with a solution?
Sure. So, I mean, I guess the first thing we did was we did a lot of need finding around this problem, this issue. And after we sort of honed in on you know, the problem that we wanted to solve, we came up with different questions that we sought to answer via prototyping, you know, answering them via physical means.
Can you talk about that prototyping stages a little bit more?
Sure. So, you know, the first set of questions that we kind of came up with during the prototyping process were very basic questions. You know, we had never built anything related to clubfoot braces before, so we just had some early, you know, questions like how does, you know, one build a clubfoot brace? What are the minimum components necessary to do that? And so our first few prototypes were very simple, quick, easy to make versions of a clubfoot brace, ideas we had. And then as we got further along down the prototyping process road, we started to come up with more intricate ideas and needed to answer more intricate questions. And so our prototypes got progressively more complex, and we needed to kind of change our materials, processes for those more complex prototypes.
What were some of the key criteria you developed to guide your design?
So we knew the solution needed to be you know, very, very cheap. We knew it needed to be durable. We didn't want it breaking in the field. And we knew it needed to be very, very easy to use, because the easier it is to use, the better compliance rates we're hoping you'll get. And lastly, we knew it had to meet certain medical specifications for a clubfoot brace. So it needs to hold the feet in a very particular angle, in a very particular way.
This seems like a long process. How long did it take you from when you first saw this problem to when you thought you had a viable solution?
So I'd actually say that it's probably taken us the past 2 years to really get a high-quality, high-res product out there.
You talked about prototyping. How many cycles did you go through?
Yeah, we probably went through 30 to 40 cycles of iterations of prototyping until, you know, we got to where we are today.